MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Today we've got a good matchup ahead between the Chicago Cubs and the Milwaukee Brewers. Striding in, Javier Baez, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Three and two now. And it's a chilly one here at the ballpark today. Thermometer reading 46 degrees at game time. High in the air out to center field. Kane is under it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward. The 3-1. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away. So a runner at first with one out now. And into bat next, former National League MVP Chris Bryant. And he takes a big swing at that one as this one's lifted high in the air and deep out to left field. And goodbye, this one ain't coming back. Standing in now, Wilson Contreras. Helping him out here as he swings and misses to fall behind a ball and two strikes. And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away. The next Cub up, Anthony Rizzo. In his career versus this pitcher, he's just 1-for-6. A swing and a ground ball to third. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single.
The left fielder, Kyle Schwarber.
To the plate now, Kyle Schwarber. And a good at bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Ian Happ.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Here now is the center fielder Lorenzo Cain to get us started in the bottom half of the first. Here now the 2-2. Sent on the ground out to second. And that's the first out. So the base is empty here with one away. And that'll bring up the versatile utility man Brock Holt. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Schwarber is over just a few steps to his right as he takes it for out number two. In is Christian Yelich. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. The 2-2. Two out, nobody on. Bounced on the ground and right at the shifted infielders. Taken in by Kipnis. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. So in now for Chicago, Jason Kipnis. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Here's another 1-2. And look out, he has to back away there and then give a little glare out to the mound. It's ball two.
Well, that'll wake everyone up. Anytime you buzz the tower like that, there's reason for people to start getting a little bit edgy.
And that misses for ball four, so it's a leadoff walk here to start the second. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Kyle Hendricks. A textbook sack bunt situation here. And he'll take no chances here as he swipes this ball away. It stays a foul ball. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And he pulls this one back in time, 2-2. Still showing bunt with two strikes, but he pulls it back. 3-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Here's Javier Baez.
The batter, number 9. Shortstop, Javier Baez.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. After it is Kane. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. So that'll bring up Jason Hayward. He worked a walk and came around to score in his first trip in this game. The 3-1. Line toward center field. And Kane will make the catch and the side is retired. Striding forward now, the Brewers cleanup hitter, Keston Hiura. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Now the 2-1.
I got 3-1.
Omar Narvaez will be next. Weak grounder down the line at third. But this will wind up foul as he runs the count full now. 3-2 pitch. Sharply hit ball back up the middle. That's a hit, the first of the new campaign for the Brewers. Stepping in now, Omar Narvaez. Grounded down the third baseline. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. The 1-2. And it's fouled away. On the ground for Kipnis. This could be two. He's got it to second for one. On to Rizzo at first, and they get them both. So base is empty now after the double play. Coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Avisail Garcia. 1-1. Hit in the air down the right field line. And foul. Hendricks has become known as a guy that's tough to take deep. So many starting pitchers find themselves snake bitten by the gopher ball, but he really limits that. Schwarber is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Here's Chris Bryant now. And remember, he hit that two-run homer his first time up.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
1-2 now as that one's fouled off. And another foul ball. The 1-2. Skied into straightaway right. After it is Yelich. Around first, he's digging for second. And that one skips up over the wall for a ground rule double. Into the box, Wilson Contreras. Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now 3-1. Hit out towards second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And they'll put the brakes on at third. Runners at the corners with nobody out.
The first baseman, number 44, Anthony.
So now to the plate, Anthony Rizzo. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it four strikeouts already, and there's your first out. Runners are at the corners with one man out. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2.
Big pitch coming up right here. He'd love for a ground ball or a strikeout.
Really pulled that one across as the slider misses well inside. Working for the punch out and the offering. Fouled off. Struck him out. And now they'll likely need a base hit to get that runner home from third. So two are gone now in the Cubs' half of the third. And that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Happ with a 2-1 count now. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
Even though it's early on in this one, anytime you get runners in scoring position, you'd like to knock them in.
Now a fastball as he has to lean out of the way there.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Yanked high and deep down the line in right. And it's a foul ball. The next 3-2. And he misses with it for ball four. So the bases will be loaded now with two away. And is the second baseman Jason Kipnis. One of the bigger spots in the ball game so far. Bases juiced now with two away. Popped him up. Nevarez is there. He's got it, and that'll get him out of the jam. Here's Eric Sogard as we move on to the bottom of inning number three.
Hey, we're still in the early stages of this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Here now the 2-2. Smoke toward the hole. A dive and he knocks it down. And there is some stick to it of this as they still manage to get the out at first. What a play. So one away here with the bases empty. And in next, the switch hitting power bat of Justin Smoke. Three balls and a strike now to Smoke. Bases are empty, one man out. And the sinker runs too low here as he loses him. It's ball four. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Brandon Woodruff. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Bunt attempt is popped into foul ground. The 1-2. Smoke, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Bit of a surprise here as he's going to try to lay one down. And they will smartly make sure this stays foul, so he fails in his attempt there and becomes the second out of the inning. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Hit hard to third. And a sliding try there at third, but it skips by him, a base hit. In now, Brock Holt, grounded to third. First, and the Brewers are turned away as the inning is over. Now at the plate, Kyle Hendricks comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. The 1-1 home. Here's a pop-up now. And he'll lunge forward to make the catch for the first out. So one away here in the Chicago fourth. And into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez. The 2-1 home. Turned on down the line. And he tries for the backhand reach at third, but he gets by the glove down the line.
Now batting, right fielder,
standing in now, Jason Hayward. Counts even to Hayward, two balls and two strikes. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
I don't even think I need to look in the dugout on this one. I think it's safe to assume he's going to be running. Too good a hitter at the plate not to think he's going to put the ball in play.
Holt for one, on to first, but not in time as he beats it out. With two runs, five hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Line drive to left. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases. Hayward blows through the stop sign, headed for home. And he's safe at the plate as they extend their lead to three. At the plate now, Wilson Contreras. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes. And here's Christian Yelich now. He's 0-for-1 thus far. 1-1 home. Is a fastball down below the knees. And this will be fouled away.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
Again, another foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. He's at the knees and called strike 3. Next for Milwaukee, Keston Hiura, a base hit in his first trip.
Keston Hiura.
Grounded weakly toward third. Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close. Digging in now, Omar Narvaez. No runs, 2 hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Off-speed pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And this one misses inside, a ball he walked him, and they've got themselves a 2-out base runner. Into the box now, Avisail Garcia. And we'll see if they can make him pay for the 2-out walk, always considered a big no-no, of course. And as it turns out, the 2-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Brent Suter is out from the bullpen now as he'll get the call here on opening day.
Number 35.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now. He's singled in 2 trips to the plate thus far. The 1-1. It is strike 2 swinging.
Count 1 and 2.
And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball.
Man, this guy's a grinder. Fouls off good pitches and doesn't seem to swing at the ones just off.
Now he spins on one here and drives it to deep right field. Gone to lead off the inning. At the plate, Kyle Schwarber. It looked like the fastball got away from him there.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
Down the first baseline. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Now a changeup locks him up as he looks at strike 3 called, 1 away.
Now batting.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that'll bring up the former first rounder and Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that's through for a hit.
Up next to the call, the second baseman, Jason Kipnis.
Into the box, Jason Kipnis. And there's ball 3 on a breaking ball that misses away.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count, you send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball 4.
Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are 2 gone.
Now batter, the pitcher.
2 out with the man at first. And this is low, ball 2, 2-1. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. As a look, now the pitch. Fouled away. Grounded back up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field.
the batter, number 9, shortstop, Javier Baez.
So now to the plate, Javier Baez.
Nope.
Two balls and a strike to Javi Baez. Two and two. The 2-2. But pulled in at the hot corner, and that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, Eric Sogard. And they'll need him to get something going here.
This one doesn't look good so far. Down by a boatload as we enter the middle innings. It's about time they get something going. And the last thing you want to do is fall behind where you have to score a bunch in the eighth and ninth inning.
Hit hard up the middle. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
Now that first baseman.
To the plate now, Justin Smoke just hung in there on that one. The 2-2. Line hard, but foul. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Chopped at the plate. That goes foul, so he stays alive with two strikes.
Hey, having AB right here, I know it's frustrating the heck out of the pitcher. You keep fouling these pitches off, maybe one misses over the heart of the plate.
Now another 2-2.
He's definitely going to want to get greedy in his zone, and he's obviously seeing the ball well, or he would have swung at that pitch. Sometimes in these long, epic at-bats, you start to get into swing mode.
And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out. The 1-2. And this is lifted high in the air down the right field line. Hayward is over, and he puts it away in foul ground for the second out. Digging in and looking for more, Lorenzo Cain. It was a single for him in his last at-bat. Ready with the 1-1. Liner towards second, but this won't get over the second baseman's glove as he's got it to end the inning. Here's Jason Hayward now. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. The 1-1. A bouncer up the middle. Fielded cleanly. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. Stepping in, Chris Bryant, hoping to build off that RBI double from his last plate appearance.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get. Maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
And he'll pull into second with his fourth hit of the ball game.
The catcher, number 40,
stepping in now, Wilson Contreras. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. All even at 2-2. Here it is. Nearly got the inside, but ruled the ball. Waiting next is Anthony Rizzo. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away. At the plate, Anthony Rizzo. He went deep last time up.
The last at bat, Matty B, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
There's a drive out to left center field. Bryant is on his way home. One run scores. Here's a second runner around third. He scores, and it's now a six-run lead. J.P. Fireisen gets the call to pitch here, and he'll try to sort this mess out. He's going to try to at least eat a couple of innings for his guys. Into the box now, Kyle Schwarber. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. From the stretch. Runner at second here with one man out. And he fouls this one off. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
The center fielder, number 8.
Digging in the switch hitter, Ian Happ. Runner in scoring position with two gone. 1-1, here it is. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. All even now, 2-2.
Hey, last two pitches back to back, off speed, then he's laid on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
Lifted in the air to center. Kane is under it, and that ends the inning. Here's Brock Holt now. A swing and a miss there, 2-2.
When your team is behind this late in the game, it's not a good look for you as a hitter to show no discipline and wave at a pitch that wasn't even sniffing the zone.
Happ picks it up. Standing in now, Christian Yelich. Grounded to the right. Kipnis has it. The second for one. On to Rizzo, but a little slow in developing as they'll just get the one out. And that'll bring up Keston Hiura. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. The 1-1. Well, he's having a good amount of success here, Dan, even though he hasn't really gotten a ton of swings and misses.
Yeah, it amazes me how every game you pitch can be so different, Matt. Sometimes it feels like guys can't touch you and you're just punching everyone out. But other times, you don't have your good stuff and you really rely on movement and location to get outs. That's been the case for him today, and it's really working.
Yelich rounds third and is digging for the plate. He comes across to score, and the deficit now stands at 5.
Now batting. The
into the box, Omar Narvaez to 1-2 now. From the belt, kicks and deals. Ground ball sent back up the middle. There's Baez. Throw gets him, 2 down. Ready once again, Avisail Garcia. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. Here comes the pitch for Garcia. Two out here and a runner at second. Hot shot on the ground is short. Baez has it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Seventh inning ready to roll. Standing in, Jason Kipnis. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out. Victor Caratini will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. Two and one. One out, nobody on. Ball And it's two balls and two strikes now.
Hey, like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor and he's swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
The 2-2. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
And it's fouled away. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he popped him up. Sogard in foul ground. And no one will track it down. Once again, a 3-2. Fouled off. And now this will be the 10th pitch of the at-bat. Popped up. Sogard is there for it. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning. And now back to the leadoff spot from the Cubs lineup. Stepping forward, Javier Baez. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Here's the 2-1 home.
That's ball three.
Jason Hayward would be next. The 3-1. Makes him swing and miss on a ball out of the zone for strike two.
Ooh-wee, that was an ugly swing. I'm sure he's not going to watch that one on replay after the game.
Grounded to short. Oh, what a stop on the slide. What a play.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time.
Alec Mills gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Number 30.
At the plate, Eric Sogard, a hit in two tries so far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Half has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first out. So the switch hitter Justin Smoke steps up. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The 1-1. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Hayward has a read on it. Two down. Ryan Braun. We'll get the call to pinch hit here as we'll see what he can do with two out and the base is empty. Three and two now. Bases are empty here with two men out. Drilled to the left side, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
The center fielder, number 6, Lorenzo Cain.
At the plate, Lorenzo Cain skied in the air to straightaway left. Schwarber will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Corbin Burns has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 39.
Ready to begin the eighth, so striding in, Jason Hayward. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Now the 3-2 pitch is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So one gone here in the Chicago eighth, and that'll bring up Chris Bryant. Fouled away. Bases are empty. One man in. Just tried to freeze him with the fastball there. Pretty close. It's 2-2. Full count. 3-2.
That was kind of a gift to the hitter. He's up there probably thinking of protecting on 2-2. But when you launch a ball that high out of the strike zone, it's obviously easy to take that one.
This is foul right side. locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a wall. The 1-1 home. Line drive, base hit to right. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
The first baseman, number 44, Anthony Rizzo.
At the plate now, Anthony Rizzo. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Another full count pitch on its way. Grounded up the first baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. Neither guy giving in. Here's the next one. That's popped up. Holt moving to his left, and he makes the catch for the second out. So coming to the plate, Kyle Schwarber. He went down on strikes last time up.
Kyle Schwarber.
A 1-1 is laid off for ball two. Two down, runners at first and second. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2. Hit well on the ground to first. A diving effort here as he gets a glove on it. And they will still manage to get him at first. A spectacular all-around play, and the inning is over. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go. Stepping in, Brock Holt. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Now the 3-2 pitch. Lifted the other way to left center. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And the Brewers get a man into scoring position on the leadoff double.
Now batting, right fielder, Christian Yelich.
To the plate now, Christian Yelich. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
2-2. No one out with a runner at second. Lifted the other way down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. This is line to left, but he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first out. Trying to pick things up where he left off, Keston Hiura. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. Hit hard on the ground to first. Rizzo was there, and he'll take this one to the bag for the out, but meanwhile the runner will move up 90 feet to third base. Standing in, Omar Narvaez. No hits to this point.
Omar Narvaez.
The 1-1 home is swung on and missed for strike number two. Bounce towards the mound. And 8 innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Alex Claudio enters from the pen to start the 9th inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the 9th. Ian Happ will be the first one to greet him as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here. Hit to third. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. Ready for another shot now, Jason Kipnis. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. Now a sinker this time, but this ball stays outside as he loses him here. It's ball four. Nico Horner will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Nico Horner.
Ground ball to second. This could be two. Reined in. One there. On to smoke, but it's too late as they'll get just the one. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Javier Baez. He was a ground out victim last time up. The 2-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Full count here. Here comes the pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Yelich is under it. And that ends the inning. Rowan Wick is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season. All set for the bottom of the ninth. So here is Avisaio Garcia. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. The set and the 1-1 pitch. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
When you've got a guy that throws a good two-seam fastball, you have to be ready for him to try to run it inside and jam you. Good job to lay off that one, but I wouldn't be surprised if we see it again.
A 3-1 count to the Brewers left fielder. A good pass at that ball just a little late, and now the count's full. 3-2 pitch. Ball hit high to the right side, but this will get into the seats. Foul. And could this be the start? It's a long way back, but the leadoff man is on base to start their final set of at-bats. A runner at first with no outs here. There's a good breaking ball as it gets the bottom of the zone.
Hey, that's a great job by the pitcher right there, stealing a strike with that get-me-over breaking ball. And now he can get a little nastier with it in the dirt.
That's through for a base hit, his second of the ball game. In now, Justin Smoke. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes.
Great job of doubling up with a fastball inside. A lot of times you'll see a pitcher go in there, but they won't go back in there a second time. This guy's not afraid to pitch inside.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. Ben Gamel will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. First and second now, one man out. And he pumps the fastball by him here, 1-2 now. Now a curveball misses inside. Full count, three balls and two strikes.
Don't be shocked if he doesn't go right back to that same pitch. You could tell he jelly-legged him at the plate a little bit, froze him, but just missed his zone.
And this will be just what the manager ordered as he's off the bench with extra bases. He pulls into second safely, as also on the play, a run comes across to score. Dan Winkler comes on here looking to get the final two outs and earn the save. So now to the plate, Lorenzo Cain. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Stepping up now, Brock Holt. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Misses, ball two.
great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
The Brewers down to their final strike. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
And a nice job here to come in and slam the door. That's his first save of the season, but it certainly won't be his last.
6-2, the final total today. The Chicago Cubs jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Kyle Hendricks gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Brandon Woodruff was only able to work four innings as he takes the loss. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Here now is our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 6 runs on 12 hits. No errors. They left 13 men on base. For the Brewers, 2 runs, 9 hits. No errors. They left 9 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 1 minute. Our paid attendance at Miller Park this afternoon, 41,900. The Brewers thank you for attending today's game and remind you to please drive home safely.